10-second countdown?
We're professional around here, man. And we are live. Do you feel the magic, guys?
Magic.
Magic time. Here with Jeffrey Dean Morgan, Norman Reedus, of course, stars of The Walking Dead. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Hey, good morning. Thanks for having us.
This is our last big day at Comic-Con. Saturday's kind of like, I feel like when it all just, everyone's brain gets scrambled because so much is going on. But you've already had like your massive day because you unleashed the trailer for the new season.
It was sparkly. Yeah. It was a sparkly
it's
day.
It's a glittery event.
Yeah. Happy with the reception? Happy with the love you're feeling right now?
Yeah, I mean, these are kind of our people out here. So we come down here and, you know, from our little bubble out in the woods and have fun with everybody. But yeah, it was great. And we have a tiger.
It's amazing. Not many shows can say that.
Yeah.
And you were telling me, I'm shocked because I was like, you know, we're all a little tired today. It's a little, we've been working hard.
Oh,
9 a.m.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Yeah. Okay. Calm down. But you've been up for a while. You have a tradition here, you were saying?
Yeah.
What have you done already today?
We got up first thing, whole cast, and jumped in the ocean. So it's 8 now, so we were in the water at, 7:30?
7:30, yeah.
You're fresh as a daisy, right out of the ocean. Amazing.
Fresh as two daisies.
Is there clothing involved? Is this like a nude swim?
No, because now people have cameras and they followed us down there, so that wasn't cool.
Oh, ruining all the fun.
That wasn't cool. Nobody wants their picture taken like we were looking this morning. In our bathrobes and black socks on.
Although Josh put on a ski cap, one of those rubber ski caps, and Speedos. And he took it very seriously.
That's almost creepy. That's like, if I saw that, I would run in the other direction.
I was impressed. I thought it was cool.
We're walking in the water, and I'm like, dude, you look fantastic. He goes, bro, I got to have salt touch my body like once a week. And I'm like, yeah, what?
You're nodding. Uh-huh. Okay, let's go with that.
Yeah, we're in the middle of Georgia.
So is Comic-Con always something that you guys look forward to? I mean, knowing like this is kind of where, I mean, you experience so much, you know, fan love all the time, but like this is a massive concentration where you feel it in an intense way, I would think.
Yeah, I mean, you know, like I said, like we don't see all this. Like we're not in Hollywood and, you know, we don't shoot where there are cameras like this. And we work really hard on something and then we come out here and party with everybody, but it's nice to get that kind of feedback. You know, it's great. It feels nice.
Well, what's the level of security about keeping the secrets for the show at this point? Like, I mean,
It's a 10.
It's a 10 out of a 1.
it's a 10, the highest it can be.
So do you ever slip up? Do you ever, like, inadvertently say something to, whether it's a journalist or a friend, and have to backtrack and try to...
You just don't say anything. Yeah. And then you get, like, half a sentence out, and then Scott goes... Let me answer that question for them. You know what I mean? So
they were very careful this year. I mean, you've seen in the panels and the press conferences we've had, they will put Gimple and Greg Nicotero and Kirkman up there. Kirkman has come closest to, like, blowing stuff.
I don't think he cares anymore.
No. He's the loose cannon.
Really?
Yeah.
He's like my party.
If you want to know stuff, go to Kirkman.
Yeah. Amazing. We have to talk about, I mean, the end of last season, which was just so talked about and discussed and argued over. Were you surprised by kind of the reaction, whether it was, like, fans satisfied or some that were not so happy with kind of the cliffhanger? Did that come as a surprise to you, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I mean, it did. I didn't think people would take it so negatively. I mean, I think a cliffhanger is good storytelling. I think that's cool. I think it's going to bring you back. But people were so pissed off that kind of surprised me. That being said, you know, I would say this. Be careful what you wish for, because when 701 comes around, you're going to be like, whoa, shoot, I probably shouldn't have been so hard on the show.
Right.
You know?
And it's not really an ending to last season. It's more of a beginning of this season.
That's right.
Right. Now, when you shot that, did you shoot the conclusion of that scene? Like, did you know where it was going?
No, we didn't shoot the... Are we allowed to say that?
I don't know. I'm not saying anything.
Forget Kirkman. Jeffrey's the best.
It's 7:30.
I can't even remember if I'm supposed to have been there.
I think that we know now that we did not shoot. I think that came out last year that we did not shoot all of the scene last year, that came this year.
And did you shoot, like, multiple different versions?
Shut up.
No. Let's talk about happy things again. The fans are the best.
They're awesome.
So how far into shooting are you right now? Are you taking a break right now for Comic-Con, or are you...
Is that we go back to work today. No, we took a 3-day break to be here, but we're in the midst of shooting. We're almost at the mid-season point.
Coming in midstream of this amazing like pop culture behemoth, were you? I mean, you knew what you were getting into and the love of this character. Has any part of this process surprised you at all, or did you kind of know what you were getting
into? Just kind of how much fun and how awesome everybody is. I was a fan of the show forever. I've seen every episode since the beginning, and I was aware of the comic book. When Negan came out, people approached me here, as a matter of fact, at Comic-Con, and it's like, you got to see this Negan character, and that was 5 years ago.
Right.
So the way it turned out is fantastic, but I think the coolest thing is this group of people.
Yeah.
Cast and crew are so great, and it's such an original, awesome experience being part of this family. That's the coolest thing.
For you, Norman, a bunch of seasons in, is the cast getting more professional or less professional on set? Are they almost too relaxed at this point? Is it a different kind of vibe on set now that you're kind of comfortable?
You know, I mean, when I first came onto the show, that precedent was already set. There was John and Sarah and Andy, and there was already we take this super serious and 110% at all times in the support of each other. So that core has stayed with us the whole run of the show so far.
Yeah.
Like there's people either join that and get it and have a great time and kill it, no pun intended, or they just don't and they sort of fizzle away. But that core has always been there. And you know, I remember the first day on set, like, oh man, these guys are all friends and stuff. And you know, and
that's right.
Falling into it and every actor gives everything they can off camera for everybody. They're always there showing support for everybody. It's just, it's kind of a nice, it's very rare in this business to have that, you know? But it was, that precedent was set from the very beginning by those three guys.
Not only do we have two of the stars of the most watched, obsessed over television show on the planet right now, but we've also got Batman's dad in the house, Thomas Wayne, R.I.P.
R.I.P.
A brief but wonderful appearance in Batman versus Superman. Any hopes of a flashback in the solo Batman movie or something? I mean, he's got daddy issues,
I'm hoping,
you know?
We do a the Flashpoint. You know that.
Oh, right.
That's my whole thing. And L.C. Lauren Cohen.
Of course.
Mrs. Wayne. Yeah. So, Mrs. Wayne.
And we got Denai, who's Tupac's dad as well. You know, so. You know what I'm saying?
Well, the other thing I wanted to mention is this video game you're in. It's basically like you're naked holding a baby. Explain yourself. What's going on?
Yeah, awesome. I mean, that we were talking about this last night. Yeah. I had dinner with him last night and his team, and that guy, like, he's such a genius, and I'm just doing whatever he says, you know. And he's like, "We're gonna make people cry." And I'm like, "For a video game?" And he's like, "Yep." And I was like, all right. And then he goes, and I go, playing me? And he goes, no, they'll be you. And I was like, I'm just doing whatever he says. I mean, I showed him the trailer, and that guy's just such a genius. And he keeps explaining more and more in depth. It's, I don't know how that guy's mind, but you know, I met him through Guillermo del Toro, who has that same sort of brilliant mind, of course.
Of
I would do a dog food commercial with both of them. Yeah, does not matter.
I would watch a Guillermo del Toro dog food commercial.
Ah, you'd
be terrified.
Like, that's a fucking great idea. That would,
it's okay. There's been a lot of profanity.
Great idea.
Yeah, I'm just following his lead. He's the man.
Nice. It seems like the two things everybody are obsessing about this past week are Donald Trump and Pokemon. We'll just cover Pokemon. Pokemon Go. Thoughts?
So confused.
Yeah.
So confused. I thought this was a trading card game, and now people are running around all over the world with their phones looking for Pokemon. All the stuff that's going on in the world right now, my Yahoo News feed, it's Pokemon number one. Trump is like six.
And glitter bombs.
What's that say about us,
Who's
Jeffrey?
Looking for Pokemon here? Yeah, there's him. My publicist in the corner.
There's probably a couple right here. Right?
You can see what my career's in the shitter. Just looking for Pokemon.
Priorities. What about you, Norman? Have you been Pokemoning?
No, but my son went through a Pokemon phase when it was still like games and cards and all that stuff. And I mean, I must have spent $10,000 on all that crap. And then one day he just went, done. And I'm like, well, what do we do with this mountain of Pokemon stuff?
You do it to my kids.
Yeah, thank God. Thank God that went away before the little, you know, Google thingy. But, you know, I hear that, you know, people are like, you know, like thuggy kids in New York are like waiting for kids to show up with their phones and like, give me your phone. You know, they're like hanging out by monsters. Yeah, that, yeah,
it's turning
you know.
Into a crime opportunity. Yeah. Yeah. Way to go, Pokemon.
Presidential politics. What superhero should be voted as the commander in chief? Who would get your vote to be our president this year?
Hulk. Smash everything.
Bust some heads.
Silver Surfer, just because he's
pretty cool.
Poetic.
Yeah. He's got no genitals.
Well. That's nice.
But you don't want a president with generals.
Either do any of the candidates now.
Ooh, let's drop it.
Nice. Almost there.
We wrap up every Comic-Con interview. We've been doing this for years at MTV with a game called Geeks and Posers because a lot of people come to Comic-Con claiming to be true geeks, but there are some posers out there.
Posers, for
sure. We'll find out. We'll find out. Some pop culture trivia for you guys. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Star Wars question. Who are, this is pretty easy, I think, who are Kylo Ren's parents?
Who the hell's Kylo Ren?
It's Han Solo and Princess Leia.
There you go.
Bam!
Who's Kylo Ren? I have no idea who that is.
What?
I seriously have no idea.
That was the movie
that was
playing at our hotel last night on the lawn.
Yeah, but we weren't facing that direction.
Guys, it's going to be okay.
I took my kid to an opening day.
So are you geeking? I'm a poser already?
Well, apparently.
Okay, let's see if we can even it out. Next, what is Mjolnir?
It's all you.
Mjolnir is the stuff that comes out of Jabba the Hutt after a big dinner.
I thought it was a type of helium balloon. I don't know. What is it?
It's actually Thor's hammer.
Oh, I thought we were on Star Wars.
Sorry. I would hope you know the next one. What is in The Walking Dead, what is Negan's weapon of choice?
Golf club.
Jeffrey, do you know the answer to that one?
Man, his charisma. Duh.
Lucille.
Lord of the Rings. Where did Frodo and Sam go to destroy the ring?
I hop.
That little dude that crawls around the rocks with the big eyes took him.
Oh, yeah, Mordor.
What? Poser here.
Was I right? That's right, right? Yeah.
All right, two more final.
Dude, that was dope.
I just like the name Mordor. I think I remembered it. Awesome.
Anybody
you can see how old your kid is from that question, because you probably took him to it.
I don't think he's ever seen that movie.
He was just alone in the theater watching it. He was, yeah, there. Vin Diesel cool. impression, anybody? Vin Diesel? That's pretty good.
I'd have to shave my head.
Okay.
And get a lot of muscles.
Yeah.
Finally, can either of you sing the Pokemon theme song?
I thought it was a trading card. I didn't know there was a song. You know it, don't you?
I really don't.
Do you know we'll hear the lyrics.
I want to be the very best like no one ever was. Catch him in my real test. This sounds like a venereal disease thing.
I don't know why you're handing this to me. Yeah, you got to catch them all.
Catch it all.
It's my destiny.
Travel across
it
the land.
Could very well be VD.
Searching for
you're right.
Yeah.
Got to catch them. Got to catch them. Courage will pull us through.
To teach me and I'll this is like a this is perverted.
So do we?
I think you
won. We're for sure geeks.
You're total geeks,
right?
Guys.
We're total
congratulations.
Geeks. Yeah, it wasn't even a question. No posing here.
Not at all. If anyone's the poser here, it's me. Congratulations on The Walking Dead continuing strong.
Thank you.
Thanks for stopping by this morning, guys.
Yeah,
always a pleasure. Good
us.
To see you guys.
Awesome,
all right, on to the next Facebook Live in a bit. Thanks for watching, guys.